Hey, what's up everybody? So in front of you we have a PayPro L bracket or L plate for the Canon R5 and the Canon R6. I'm going to give you a full unboxing of it and a quick overview. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. So there are a bunch of other L brackets or L plates on the market. You have Small Rig, you have RRS, which is really right stuff. You also have Kirk, but I was looking for something that had a little grip to the bottom to give a little bit height to it. So it brought me to PayPro. So let's go ahead and take a look at it. So here's the box. It's really nothing much to it, just a brown box. And inside you have your plate. Inside you have two tools. So this bigger one is for these two here. And you have your smaller one for the side L bracket. So let's go ahead and take a look at the plate. So you have your bracket here to let you hold the camera in portrait mode or vertical. And you have your bottom plate here for landscape or horizontal. And both are Archetype Swiss compatible. So if you have a plate or tripod, you can mount it on. You do have additional quarter 20 and on the sides as well, so you can mount lights, monitors, microphones. And you have easy access to your battery door. And you have a slot here for hand strap or any type of loop. And you are able to also store the tool inside. And with this screw here, when you take it out, you're able to remove the L plate. So that's one good thing about it. I'm not much of an L bracket person. I mainly bought this for the Arca Swiss and for the extension where your pinky is. But let's go ahead and install this onto the R6. So to install the plate onto the camera, simply take the tool, line up the bottom, and tighten down the screw. And once you have it tightened down, you can go ahead, install the tool, and it'll be held down by magnets. So here, about an inch or so added to the bottom for your pinky. And since this is going across straight, your camera will sit flush. There's no wobble or being lopsided. And you still have full access to your articulating screen with no problem. Obviously, once it's inside, you're limited on how much you can rotate. And here is the access to the battery door. I don't have nails, so it's harder for me to get. Wish it was, the height of this was a little bit shorter, but if I did have nails, that's how it would open. So easy access to the door, nothing blocking the battery door. And here's my hand with it. So now there's more room. Before it was just this right here. But now I can spread out my hands a little bit more because the plate adds an extra thickness to it, additional height. Whereas with others, plate comes up to here and that's about it. So it comes up to about right there, right before the battery door. And then you have this portion, that's the plate. And then you have the L bracket. So let's go ahead and take this off. And to take it off, and this is how it looks like without it. So by you removing it, now you do have a slight gap inside. No big deal. But if you use Peak Design straps, you can either mount it on the bottom here, or you can actually loop it through here. And with this L bracket, you can also adjust how far you want this to be sticking out as well. So if you're plugging in cables, you can have it stick out and tighten it down. And you still have access to your screen. Just that now this bracket or plate is blocking the screen. So it's all personal preference. I may leave this on, I may take it off. I'm not a big L bracket person. And these two small screws here allow you to move it forward and back. Obviously, moving it back, you cover the ports. And as you can see, you're blocking your HDMI cover. So that's why you would stick it out to give you access to the ports. And I'll show you how it looks like when you remove these two screws, if you don't want them, and how it looks like. So with the two screws removed, you're left with just these two. Now you don't have that weird opening. So again, personal preference. If you're not an L bracket person, you can just remove this and leave the bracket on, or you can remove it completely and take it out. So let's go ahead and mount the Canon R6 onto an ArcaSwiss ball head and see how the plates work. So here I just have a generic KingJoy G1 ball head and Platypod Ultra. here is the R6 with the Pay Pro L bracket. And here's how it looks like. And let's take a look at it with it mounted horizontal on portrait mode. There you go. And here's a shot of it with my RF 24-70. And here's a shot with the R6 with the 35mm macro. And a 3D printed lens hood. And here's a shot of the R6 with a Mikkei EF to RF lens adapter and the Canon 70-200 f2.8 Mark III. Any questions, leave a comment down below. We'll leave a link in the description to where you can purchase the Pay Pro R5, R6, L bracket or L plate. Hit the subscribe button, like this video, give this video a thumbs up, hit the bell notification to be notified of when we have new videos. Till next time, see ya.